What's up, everybody? Today we're going to ride a sea turtle. And we're going to catch it all on film. See that guy over there? That's me. My name is Brian Sheahan. And here we are at the Living Planet Aquarium in Sandy, Utah. But before we ride the turtle, we got to see what happens when we put our submarine, called the Sea Perch, in a tank with this shark.
The idea is to have more engineers out in the field because a lot of kids think it's boring, but it's actually really fun to create stuff, so I like it.
What I meant to say is really we just want to get kids more excited about engineering. What I've got in my hands is a little remotely operated vehicle, an ROV. It's made out of PVC pipe and a few motors. Attached to the front of the sub is a suctioning device. It's really easy to make. All it is a bilge pump, a small pump, with the head I created out of PVC pipe and a rubber gasket. Thankfully, everything seemed like it was going according to plan.
This is one of our back of house holding tanks at the Living Planet Aquarium. This is our white tip reef shark living here, and the sub. Everything seems to be going well. We weren't sure how the animals would respond to the sub. They do not care at all, which is what we were hoping, what I was hoping. It really doesn't seem to impact it at all. So we're going to go ahead and try it in the bigger tank with more sharks and see how they respond.
In the big tank, there are unicorn and shovelnose fish, stingrays, eight sharks, and my favorite, the green sea turtle. And let's not forget the sea perch.
I feel so close to you right now, it's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall. And there's no stopping us right now. I feel so close to you right now.
So in the end, as you saw, we didn't catch a ride on the turtle's back for two reasons. One, it was too busy eating the food on the top of the water. And two, this turtle has a weight on the back of its shell because it can't dive. It was rescued from the wild from Florida after being hit by a boat and bitten by a shark. And when the turtle's shell healed, an air pocket was inside and it still remains in there today, so it can't dive under the water very well. This is called bubble butt syndrome. So pretty much every time, we just had to dive underneath the turtle instead of riding on its back. But we were still determined to catch a ride on a turtle. So we called in a favor with one of our friends, a ninja turtle. Cowabunga, dude. This time we used the camera sub with the suction pump, and so all we got was this footage of us riding around on the turtle shell. And afterwards, the Ninja Turtle even gave us a private interview. He even saved our lives.
Why did you decide to do the Sea Perch program, Ninja Turtle?
Oh, you know, well, I just really like the BYU kids. They came up to me and asked if I could help them out. So I got this shell, and they wanted to like test to see if their like little ROV could like hold on to my shell and get some suction. So I figured, why not? It's a good cause. But anyways, oh my goodness, a zombie!
Now that the zombie's gone, I have one more question for you. Okay. Why are you so white?
Oh, right, dude. That's a great question. I'm actually an albino ninja turtle, one of the only ones in the world. And that's how it's done. What's up, everybody? Thanks for watching. At the end of the video, I just want to say a few things. First of all, kids, it's fun to be an engineer. You get to create stuff and do a lot of fun projects. And at the end of the day, when you're grown up, you'll be able to make a lot of money, too. So hope you enjoy it and be engineers, kids.
Alright, smile.